King Corso and South African Boerboel, two popular domestic dogs that are very similar in so many ways. They can both be trained to guard and to protect, and if raised properly, both can be great family pets too. However, these two breeds also have many key differences too. Here's the five key differences of a King Corso and a South African Boerboel.
Here we go, at the top of the class on a roll. And it's time to run it up, yeah, you know. Maxed out, put the pedal to the floor. Hey, on a roll, here we go, here we go.
There are several differences we need to know between Boerboels and King Corsos. First is their appearance. Boerboels can weigh 150 pounds to 200, while Corsos can only weigh 90 pounds up to 110. This makes Boerboels be 50% and 100% larger than a King Corso. In addition, Boerboels are usually neutral colors like cream, tawny, or brown, while Corsos are often brindle, gray, and black. Furthermore, Boerboels' coats are much shinier and smoother than a Corso's. Second is their temperament. The Boerboel is one of the strongest dog breeds on the planet, as well as one of the biggest dog breeds. They are highly intelligent and territorial. Although both are highly intelligent breeds, the King Corsos tend to be quirkier than a Boerboel. The King Corso is very playful, while the Boerboel is more territorial. The King Corso tends to do better being the only dog in the family, as it requires a lot of attention and is not keen on strangers. Third is their trainability. Both the King Corso and the Boerboel are easy to train. However, the Corso is more active and tends to be more open to learning social skills. The Boerboel can be trained with weights to build their muscles for sporting and hunting. Just keep in mind, both breeds are strong-minded dogs that are not to be pushed around. Fourth is their life expectancy. Both breeds are similar in life expectancy. Although the Boerboel is known to live a bit longer, both the Boerboel and King Corso can live past 10 years, with many living up to 11 and 12 years old. This is about the average for most dog breeds. It should be noted that the Boerboel tends to run into more health issues than a King Corso and other dog breeds in general. Fifth is their energy levels. The Boerboel is an extremely active dog, especially when it is young. This breed excels at agility challenges, obedience competitions, protection exercises, and agricultural labor, to name a few. The Boerboel thrives as a pet at a home with a well-fenced yard and plenty of room to run around. The Boerboel is a tough breed to own, and it is not recommended for inexperienced dog owners. On the other hand, Corsos have worked as battle dogs, large game hunters, guardians, agricultural workers, and more. Although their lengthy history, thanks to their huge physique and protective disposition, if the Boerboel has an average energy levels, King Corso is on a high energy level. They have recovered popularity in recent years after nearly disappearing during the post-war period and are now among the top 25 most popular dog breeds in the United States. In conclusion, both the Boerboels and King Corsos are fiercely protective of their loved ones and their property. They'll warn you about anything they think is suspicious, and they'll put themselves between you and anything or anyone they think is a threat. Because of their intelligence and desire to be trained, both canes are very playful, fetching, or even used as show dogs on occasion. Either way, they both make good family dogs, although the King Corso seems to be a better fit for more experienced dog owners. That's it for today's video, Boerbuds. I hope you learned something today. If you want to know more about South African Boerboels, feel free to drop by our website at www.boerboelpuppy.com and check out our available puppies for sale. If you are new here, don't forget to hit like, share, and subscribe to be updated on our next video. Peace! Julep, pop, 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 pop
Roll up.